Hello, everybody, and welcome back to my series, Revisiting the Wizarding World, where we go back and rewatch and re-review every single Harry Potter movie in the Wizarding World, including the Fantastic Beasts franchise. And at the very end, we're going to be ranking them from worst to best. So make sure you hit subscribe and ring that bell notification so you don't miss out on any of those videos, including that epic finale. But in today's video, we are talking about the sixth entry in the Harry Potter franchise, and that's Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. As Harry begins his sixth year at Hogwarts, he discovers an old copy of Advanced Potion Making that's marked the property of the Half-Blood Prince. And with it, he's able to navigate some tips and tricks through the Wizarding World, as well as learn some more about Lord Voldemort's dark past. Now, as I mentioned last week, director David Yates is the only director throughout essentially the rest of the franchise from the previous film. So I'm not really going to delve too much into the directors, as from now on, they're going to be just the same guy. And he fairly remains consistent throughout each piece of work. I may bring him up again a little bit in the Fantastic Beasts review, but for the most part, things are pretty much the same. Half-Blood Prince also sees us getting a new professor, but this time it's not in the Defense Against the Dark Arts position. It's actually filled by former potions master Snape, but rather we get a new potions master in the name of Horace Slughorn. Slughorn is played by the amazing Jim Broadbent and is obsessed with collecting the best of the best that Hogwarts has to offer and more or less groom them for his favor in the future and his own benefit. But really why Slughorn is even there is so that they can find some very specific details about Lord Voldemort's past to help defeat him. And I cannot gloss over the information that they learn. In the end, we find out that Voldemort has created 7 Horcruxes in which pieces of his soul live so that he can essentially never die. Some of these we've seen in the past, such as Tom Riddle's diary, and Dumbledore even sports a ring that is slowly deteriorating his hand. And to be honest, Half-Blood Prince often goes quite unnoticed in the franchise, which is kind of very strange because it has a very solid story and has probably one of the best scores in the entire franchise. But what makes Half-Blood Prince stand out more than any other is its solid return to Hogwarts and the lives of the students that we haven't really seen since the first two films. We get to see the ups and downs of the three main characters as they struggle with classes, relationships, trying out for Quidditch, and just trying to fit in. Even the localized villain of Hogwarts, Draco Malfoy, gets an entire arc that we aren't even truly made aware of until late in the film, in which he's tasked with infiltrating and killing Dumbledore for the Dark Lord. He marginally succeeds, and though he isn't the one to kill him personally, it is still somewhat difficult to watch the death of Albus Dumbledore by the end of the movie. But Half-Blood Prince also does contain some of the funnier moments of the entire series, such as with the twins' joke shop, Ron's Quidditch tryouts, and Harry winning and later using the Felix Felicis potion. But despite this, it also contains very large omissions from the book, which are several characters becoming prefects and Harry having a lot more time to himself. But I do have to say that despite these omissions, the movie almost works better without these moments and actually flows quite nicely. Visually, however, the movie doesn't quite go over the top or do too little. In fact, it's very ideal as to what a good story that largely takes place within Hogwarts and uses smaller effects and CG to its benefit rather than going too big or too bold. And honestly, I can really appreciate that. The overall tone and look of the film may seem a bit odd and off-putting at times considering the previous entries, but if you focus more on the story and larger things that are happening, it's actually probably one of the strongest films of the franchise. So those are my overall thoughts on Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. It's pretty solid all around, but where does it rank on my list? For that, you're gonna have to like this video, subscribe, and ring the bell notification so you don't miss out on that epic finale. We're gonna rank all of the Wizarding World movies. But while you're down there, make sure you let me know in the comment section what exactly is your favorite Harry Potter movie or what your favorite moment from Half-Blood Prince is. I would love to read and have a conversation with you. And for even more content from me, head over to the Nerdgenic YouTube channel where you can find even more videos that I'm doing all the time, including fun watch parties, live streams, in my History of series that I give you the history of various comic book characters, heroes, and villains, and other random videos that I may post all the time. So make sure you give them a subscribe as well. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it, and I hope to see you in the next video.